A necessary measure for something so catastrophic. A countrywide shutdown took effect on Thursday in Samoa as hundreds of medical, government and international volunteers carried out a mass vaccination program. With over 60 deaths so far and more than 4,000 confirmed measles cases, locals are doing everything they can to help contain the virus.
I live in Moomoa, which is very close to Apia, and just travelling down the road and you just see all these red flags all along the street. There's a feeling of sadness, of darkness. It's just sad because everywhere you go there are no children about as well. People just don't want any more children to die, and people are uniting in every way possible to try and help contain the spread of the measles. No one is going to be left behind, and that's what the emergency team here is saying, that everyone will be getting immunised.
Although local travel on the island has been limited, those outside the country are weighing up the risks of going ahead with their travel plans.
One of my reporters was saying that his family may have to cancel their reunion. However, a lot of them have already booked their flights, paid all the hotels and resorts. So, you know, they're sort of weighing up, do they come, do they bring their kids, or do they cancel everything?
Belle Singh and her family had to cancel their trip to attend a family event. It was too risky to travel with children.
It was meant to be a very significant trip for our family, and it was a hard decision for us to make. Obviously, I think the wiser choice was to pull out of that decision of going because of the risk that was posed on my three-year-old nephew and my one-year-old nephew. We're absolutely devastated. I think what's happened has just been a really huge eye-opener. It's way too close to home. Not only are we mourning for our children, but there are also so many sick people there that need help.
Meanwhile, Pacific people have responded in force online to an offensive cartoon published in the Otago Daily Times on Tuesday, leaving many feeling disillusioned.
To say I'm disappointed is an understatement. I think there's definitely a lack of responsibility and ownership in regards to Samoa being one of our neighbouring countries. It's really sad to think that it went through those approvals and no one really stopped to think, okay, how would this make, you know, Samoans or even just Kiwis in general, how would that make them feel as a nation, knowing that our Samoa is mourning, and they thought that it would be appropriate to make a joke of it.